And the film and TV charity is in the chat with a heart emoji there. Thank you so much to the film and TV charity for being in the chat. We've not even gone for an hour and we're 40% to our goal. Thank you so much to the film and TV charity. Once again, this is all in aid of. What are the figures on your printer? Is that a printer at the back?
I've got a Jody because I thought I'll dress it pretty, like. And then I've got an Agador from Curse of Peladon.
Okay.
Obviously, the show came back in 2005, you know, and oh, Jodie's fallen over.
Oh no, Agador got her.
Yeah, Agador got her. Let's not use that as a metaphor for the merchandise range.
Was left to rot in their wake.
Now, shout out to they've done it frequently before. The CGI artist who has done stuff for this, the Respond to All Calls trailer is so wonderful. Also, I am going to pause this every so often because I do not want to get a content ID claimed. Look at this image, just Chad Eccleston. Not only is Chad Eccleston here, we also have Annette Badland, Danny Redfern, Annette Chadland. The end of a Doctor Who era, the 13th Doctor's TARDIS dismantled. According to a post on Instagram, the 13th Doctor's TARDIS interior set at Rothrock Studios in Cardiff is in the process of being dismantled. However, the Instagram image is now no longer there. It was there a couple of days ago when I put this link in, but it was one of the roundels has been taken off the TARDIS wall and is now in someone's possession. Someone might be I don't want to say getting fired, but it's also possible to talk about the idea of the fob watch, because it ties into the finale with the master. And because in the novel, it takes the form of the consciousness is like a cricket ball.
It's a cricket shape. Ball in the novel.
Yeah.
And it was a cricket ball for the longest time in the TV version, until Julie Gardner, well, just literally opened the door, poked her head in while me and Russell were talking, and said, it's a fob watch. Mm. Watch, open, close. It's out, it's in. And then she literally closed the door and left again.
So thank you so much to Michael Valentine for donating $19.63. 1963, thank you so much. Michael also says, thank you for being a well-spoken ally on behalf of the LGBTQIA community during the Turf Stuff in Your Country. Right, Winnie. Winnie says trans rights. It is. And also, I apologise if my cats decide to intervene.
Oh,
as
no
well.
Problem. So, beautiful cats.
So this is Winnie. Hello. We've got people in the live chat at the moment who are hyped about Master. So,
great.
You got Jeremy saying,
I can't see anyone. Is that right, by the way? I can't see any live chat.
That's okay. I'll read out anything relevant. But yeah,
okay,
it's all good. I can filter through the, for some reason, Peppa Pig discourse that's happening in the chat. But
Morris. Doctor Who is Aliens of London. It's never been bettered. Ooh. I love Aliens of London so much. I love the music. I love the look of it. It's so colourful. I think that was a brilliant thing Russell did, was he just went, made it colourful, made Doctor Who cheerful to look at. Mm. I love the clothes that Rose is wearing. It's colourful. And Big Ben being hit and the pig and Tos from Torchwood's there, you know, turns out to be Tos from Torchwood. There's just an unit and there's just so much, and lots of Jackie, which is always, you know, the best Doctor Who, lots of Jackie.
The Doctor must convince the monks that not only is he not their enemy, but the real foe is living amongst them. Their ancient master, Padmasavabhava. He's being controlled by the alien entity known only as the Great Intelligence. Because Big Finish are doing Gerry Anderson Thunderbirds ranges at the moment. Have you?
Yes, which I knew nothing about. I knew nothing about it, which is so crazy.
I understand that things might be a bit secretive, but have you at the very least gotten in touch with the powers that be and said, "Can I? Is there room for one more in this cast for Thunderbirds?
If I had the chance, honestly, I would be on it like a shot, but All the big roles are taken, and you know, of course John Coleshaw's in there doing all the great stuff as is Parker, my lady. And I thought if I was to do something other than the War Doctor, if it was something to do with Thunderbirds, I'd like to have a go at good old Parker. Should I bring the Rolls Royce red now, my lady? But no, John's doing it, and he's great.
Thank you for subscribing. If you are new to the channel, if you have not subscribed, then please feel free to do so. No pressure, folks, but the next person who subscribes will be my 22nd 1,000 subscriber 2,199 subscribers. Yes, my lads! 22,001 subscribers. So, let's do a quiz. This is from The Tab. Take this quiz and we'll tell you which naff Doctor Who alien you are. Right, let's not beat around the bush or mince our words, says Harrison Brocklehurst. For some reason, he's got trash next to his name. Harrison, don't put yourself down like that, man, okay? Right? We're all friends here. Yeah, my boy! Adipose. I'm not being shady here, but you are literally a blob of smiley fat. We're going to try and keep that bottom left corner, okay? Right. The system has failed, folks. The system has completely broken down through no one's fault but my own, okay? Cat time. Mwah. This is Winnie. Black cat. Do you have anything to say to the audience? I think she was born as a stray, like outdoor cat, but she's an indoor cat now. Mainly for everyone else's safety. I've got the sense that if Winnie were to go outside into the alleyway, she would be ruling the back alley by the end of the day. Yeah, we got Sylvester into the corner. Great. Yeah, here we go. Yes. Yes. Yeah, McGann. We got a War Doctor in an astonishing feat of gaming ingenuity. Okay, this is now officially a gamer live stream, so Davis says, oh no, will I check back in and look how far we've fallen? No, we're a gaming live stream now, Davis. We're a gaming stream. We're dabbing and everything. There are like 8 McGann brothers. That's true. That's a big family. Just make sure it's the right McGann brother. Can you imagine if we combine 2 Sylvester McCoys and bloody Joe McGann turns up? Oh, yep. 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 Yes! Crabs in chat for Eccleston. 40 Types says, Will, live rendition of Matt Smith moment of the week. The Matt Smith moment of the week. The Matt Smith moment of the week.
I was prepping and they needed some second year. I was like, well, you know what? I'll shoot that for you. And which was just a great way to meet the crew. And so my very, very first shot, like it's not part of my block, but it was in episode 2, War of the Suntarans. And it was a shot with an actor, a cannon, 20 extras running along and lots of explosions going off. And I was like, that's my first shot of Doctor Who. I'll start as you mean to go on.
My fifth and final recommendation for getting somebody into the classic series, as we have reached the goal just now, is the Hand of Fear. We just passed the goal. The Hand of Fear. I can't believe we reached the goal. We did it. We have... we have 3.25 hours left to go, and We've smashed the target. We've got Anonymous 13, who donated £100.13, saying this is a wonderful cause, helping those in the industry who have been set back. But we keep going as we are all strong. You are kind, and I'd be proud to call you part of the fam. 13, Anonymous 13, signed off the message 13. I wonder. I've just confirmed someone from the film and TV charity will be joining us at 8:30. And Jamie Magnus Stone has entered the Zoom chat.
I was just going to say, I've actually been subscribed to you for like 3 years, and I've quite often tune into the live streams anyway. So it's
no
really nice to finally be on one. Yeah, I'm quite a sort of a shy person online. I'm quite reclusive. So I've never sort of chimed in with anything. But I've been watching ever since those kind of... Cyber Jeff and Cyber Steve skits that I thought were brilliant back when I was doing Ascension of the Cybermen. They really cracked me up.
Oh my god.
Bit of a fan.
Oh, brilliant. Well, thank you so much. I did not expect that. We've got the chat is flipping out now at that revelation. Thank you so much. A question from Alex Rooney, who asks, what's it like working in the TARDIS set?
The TARDIS crystal never works, basically. It's like whenever there's a scene that the TARDIS needs to fly, I'd say 80% of the time, the TARDIS, the crystal breaks down. So there was a bit of a cheer the last time that I had to switch the crystal on, because we quite often have to sort of fix that in post and make it go up and down. But it's quite good for sound when it breaks, because it makes a big, makes quite a big noise to kind of go up and down. And actually, I just today got sent, I don't know if you can see back there, this is, I got sent a bit of it in the post because they've dismantled it now. Hang on.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow.
So they sent me a chunk of TARDIS because they've dismantled it. So I'm going to see if I can mount that on my wall now.
It would have been very funny if they sent you the broken crystal.
Yes. No, I'm sure that's been ceremonially melted or something.
No, but you've got a roundel. £10 donation plus £2.50 in gift aid from Harvey Smith. Thank you. He'll blush reading this most likely, but working with Trobby has been an absolute pleasure. Macra's in chat for the wonderful work this man has done for a brilliant cause. Macra's in chat now. That's what Harvey said. That's not me. Yay, Macra. There's no such thing as Macra. Thank you. Milsey Who in the chat pointing out Drashig in the background.
Oh yeah,
it looks like Drashig's like the mafia boss to the Dalek subservience.
Yeah, they're his boys. They do his bidding for him.
It's like those memes, like, oh, when me and the lads have had the vaccine and we're gonna go out on the town.
Yeah, you've got the different brands of COVID shot.
There we go. So which one's the Dolly Parton one?
Yellow. Going to the extent of making a narrow Dalek, then why not make it so it works perfectly in 4x3? And congratulations. Sorry, I was rambling.
No, that's fine. Sorry, I just thought I'd do a cheeky cutaway. The Dark Prince donated £6 to get us over the threshold. We've smashed two stretch goals. We've also got Cullen Artwork asking, John, what drawing tablet do you use?
I have a Wacom Cintiq Pro 24-inch. I took out a loan.
Wait, a 24-inch drawing tablet? A beefy, yeah. beefy.
Hang on. Let's see if I can try and get a little of it into camera. You won't be able to see all of it, but it's on these arms, so I can break that and rotate it into position.
Wow.
And then I've got my pen on top. So then I just draw away.
So it's a 24-inch tablet. So I'm going to watch Cuphead on my phone the way it was clearly meant to be seen. There we go.
Yeah, please do that. In fact, not Cuphead, that feature film. That feature film, which has been, they're hoping to put in cinemas, just watch it on your phone. Just watch it on your phone. I didn't spend hours getting eye lines right. For no other reason, so people could watch it on their phones.
So Sophie Isles is someone who has been in the chat. So Sophie has DM'd me on Twitter saying, if you like, you can show my first look at my Doctor Who birthday drawing before it's posted on Twitter today. Anyone want to see that? Anyone want to see it? Yeah. Well, you've got that little... One second, let me get rid of my webcam. There we go. Happy birthday, Doctor Who. Just a quick reminder, we have changed the stretch goal to 26.03. We're 90% of the way there. Voice of Tardis says, Mrs. Tardis Q&A. Yes, it's what many of you have been waiting for. Andrew asks, are you going to make a video on how the viewing figures are calculated? I know this is aimed at me, but you've asked it during the Mrs. Tardis Q&A. So are you going to make a video on Doctor Who viewing figures, yes?
Yeah, definitely.
There we go. Aidan Woodhead asks, is Will a nightmare to handle?
Yes.
This Q&A is over. Saying, woo, happy birthday, Doctor Who. Thank you so much, buddy. We're 1 minute away from the end. Oh, what the heck? The bar just jumped. Jack Christie with a £150 donation. Hey, folks, this is Future Will. In fairness to me, I'd been streaming for 12 hours, but I read the name wrong. It's Jake Christie. Jake Christie, thank you so much for that donation at the end. It's hugely appreciated. Thank you, Jake Christie. With the message, me again, just wanted you to get to target before the end. Worthy cause. So in 12 hours, we've managed to raise £2,608.64. Like I said, so many people who were in the Discord server and everything last night knew how nervous and worried I was about this live stream today. And you've all really come together today. So thank you very much for being here for the live stream, for all 12 hours, for coming together on Doctor Who Day, the 58th anniversary of the show we all love. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll see you all next time.